Another big and expanding story in the American West involves the wildfires in California, Colorado, and in New Mexico, where one of the fires doubled in size on Saturday.
Yeah, hundreds of folks are forced from their homes in the extreme heat, which has just been fueling that fire. It's about to get worse, and Rob's tracking it all for us this morning. Rob, good morning.
Hey, good morning, guys. Also very dry. We'll talk more about that in just a second. But all those fires happening across New Mexico and Colorado overnight, we had a new one spawned in Southern California.
This morning, out-of-control wildfires roaring across parts of the West and showing no signs of slowing down. A new blaze igniting in Laguna Beach, California. Overnight, that inferno triggering mandatory evacuations for thousands of residents. Gusty winds creating treacherous conditions for emergency crews. The uncontained fire growing to 200 acres. An aerial assault ordered to put out the flames. In New Mexico, firefighters still battling a fierce fire in Colfax County that's doubled in size over the last day. Still 0% contained, more than 30,000 acres charred, 300 homes potentially in its path, 14 structures destroyed, including a ranch belonging to the Boy Scouts of America. Evacuees still unsure when they can return home. And in Colorado, hundreds forced out of their homes by the 416 fire north of Durango. More than 1,000 acres engulfed, also 0% contained. Roads closed as firefighters continue to beat down the flames.
And it has been very dry out there. Here's a drought monitor. There are 8 states that are in extreme drought. There's a combination of things, including last year's Pacific hurricane season was pretty weak, so they didn't get a lot of moisture, not a lot of moisture across the south over this winter. So that's the issue there. We might get a little rain across eastern New Mexico today, but also some thunderstorms that may be dry with more lightning across parts of Arizona. Meanwhile, where we don't want any more rain, and we're getting it again today, flood watches across the mid-Atlantic, including D.C. and Baltimore and Richmond. This low continues to spin. It's going to get squeezed out with a front today, so more in the way of rain coming in this area this afternoon. A lot of these areas have seen twice the normal amount of rain for the month of May, so we're starting out June on a wet note as well.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.